Shalom.
I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to Biblical Hebrew Foundation.
And today I'm going to be speaking to you about the tree of life, Etz HaChaim. What is the tree of life and what does it mean in biblical context? But before we do that, we're going to go a little review over the word Torah. What does Torah mean? Torah means God's instruction. So when you read in your Bible the word law, it really says God's instruction. In no way are we saying to follow what the rabbis teach. We only follow what Yeshua said, what Yeshua teaches. He is the Word. John chapter 1, verse 14. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. In Hebrew, and the Word became flesh and tabernacled among us. He is the Word. He is God. With this understanding, we can have a look at the tree of life in the garden. I have here on the screen a picture of the two trees in the garden. We have one, the tree of life, Etz HaChaim, which is Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach. He is the tree of life. And next to the tree of life, I have a picture of a Torah scroll. Because the tree of life is the Word, and the Word is the Torah, and that's where we have a picture of the Torah scroll. The other tree is the tree of good, the knowledge of good and evil. And I have a picture of the Babylonian tower next to it, because the tree of the knowledge of good and evil is the Babylonian system, the world system. The tree of life is the biblical system, is the system of the believers are supposed to follow, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus. He is the Word. He is the Torah. You can't serve two masters. Either we serve the tree of life, Jesus, or we serve the Babylonian system, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. We're going to have a look at the book of Proverbs. So we're going to be looking at chapter 3, verses 1 and verses 18. I want to give a little overview about the book of Proverbs in chapter 3. The whole chapter 3 is speaking about the Torah, God's instruction, the Word. So that is the context of chapter 3. With that understanding, let's read Proverbs chapter 3, verse 1. My son, do not forget my teaching, but keep my commandments in your heart. In Hebrew it says, my son, do not forget my teaching, but keep my Torah in your heart. This would match the New Covenant teaching in the book of Yirmiyahu, Jeremiah chapter 31, verses 31 to 34, that God says, I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah, not the covenant of Abraham you broke, but I will write now the Torah on the hearts of man. And this matches here Proverbs chapter 3, verse 1. My son, do not forget my teachings, but keep my Torah in your heart. That is the new covenant. The Torah is written on our hearts. Let's have a look at Proverbs chapter 3, verse 18. And we're going to see that the tree of life is Jesus, but it's also the Torah. She is a tree of life to those who embrace her, to those who lay hold of her will be blessed. She is a tree of life. Now, why does it say she? Because in Hebrew, the word Torah, the RH is feminine. So therefore, the word she here, it says she is a tree of life because Torah is feminine according to the Hebrew text. So we see right here that the tree of life is Jesus. The tree of life is the Word. And Yeshua is the Torah. The context is very clear. So it's impossible to separate the Torah from the tree of life and from Yeshua. If you say, we're not under the Torah, we're under grace, you're saying we're not under God's instruction, and you're really saying, I don't want to follow Yeshua, I'm under grace, because Yeshua is the tree of life, and the tree of life is the Torah, as we see, and we cannot separate the two. But once again, very important to realize, not to follow the rabbis. We don't do that, we don't teach that, we follow only Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus. In the book of Hidgalut, Revelation 22. Now we're looking here at the end of the book, Revelation 22. We're at the end of the chapter. And here's what it says. Blessed are those who wash their robes. Now what robes is he speaking about? The Bible says that all of us have fallen short of the glory. But through him we become righteous. Through him we become priests. And it's speaking here about the robes of the priest. We are priests through Yeshua HaMashiach. So blessed are those who wash their robes, the robes of the priests, that they may have the right to what? To the tree of life. What is the tree of life? The tree of life is Jesus. As we saw in the Bible, the tree of life is the Torah. And may go through the gates of the city. What city is he speaking about? It's speaking about the New Jerusalem, Yerushalayim HaChadasha. So we see that Torah is very, very important. We see it here in chapter 22 in the end of the book. We saw it in the garden in the beginning of the book. The tree of life is Jesus, because everything from Genesis to Revelation is the same. And everything in the Old Testament is a shadow of the new. So it's very important to realize that we want access to the tree of life. What is the tree of life? The tree of life is the Torah. Abide in me, and I will abide in you, Jesus says. We must be followers of Jesus, of Yeshua HaMashiach. Die in Messiah Yeshua daily.
Repent and abide in his word. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Israel in the mighty name of Aliyeh Yehuda, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Yeshua. Amen.
Sharon has died, aged 8.
Agent, we are with one of Rabbi Kaduri's disciples.
Ba, la sala ba mi ra, que tof bi es mi shia sitel be karov na mat. Ve vas ya shpia za kol kadu ro. Nas na shem shma. Ni shem kadu ni, na shem kadu ni.